toilet. Let's get out here. Back to Mandarin Oriental where I park my bike. Because who pays for 1 ringgit parking at KLCC? No thank you. So, it's very hard to actually go around with these glasses because it's fucking dark. Never mind. Still reporting on KLCC. KLCC Plenary Hall. And all the workers here are getting for their payment little tushy tushy things or pillows. Lovely. So I'm gonna walk back to Mandarin Oriental. It's quite a short walk away. And that's why I prefer to park at Mandarin Oriental, because it's so bloody near. If I were to park in KLCC, I'd walk quite a long way. It's quite a long way because there's a connection between the middle of KLCC, which is where you come out from the parking, motorcycle parking proper for KLCC. I know it's confusing. This is called KLCC Convention Center, and there also it's called KLCC. But truth to be told, it's actually called Suria KLCC. This one is KLCC proper. KLCC, KL is Kuala Lumpur, CC is Convention Center. And this is a convention center. There are four halls, and that's only on the ground floor. There are more stuff upstairs. Downstairs on the lower ground floor, there would have a cafeteria, a subterranean tunnel to the Suria KLCC, and of course an aquarium, which I haven't actually visited at all. So you have seen already the influences of Malaysia or Southeast Asia, Vietnam, Thailand, Singapore, Indonesia, and we did not include Laos. Or Myanmar, not sure why. Maybe they don't have internet connection at all, who knows. But never mind. Influences are everywhere in Malaysia. They are small, they are not really that popular, but among their fans, no matter how many fans that they have, those fans are quite ardent fans, very, very passionate. Most of them will be Instagrammers, YouTubers and whatnot. So, and YouTubers, of course. Of course, a lot of people, when you're YouTubing, they'll be looking at you, they'll be cringing their eyes and or furrowing their eyes, thinking, how do you actually make money? Because they are not that worse in how do you actually make money. Well, initially you start out with AdSense, where you get a small minute amount of cent. That it's not much, but you have to be super popular to make it last or make it a lot of money, enough for you to eat food. For me, currently I'm around roughly about 500-600 ringgit a month, so it's not much, it's just enough to buy food. But I'm on an instant noodles diet, and of course I'm at the mercy of the hawkers who normally treat me to good food. And it's not much you make, but if you get popular then or you develop a following or people that likes your content, maybe say Wilson Lee of Singapore, and maybe there are 40 guys of you out there who might like my content, and some asshole loves to dislike my videos, I'm not sure why. Fuck you, asshole. But never mind. So, YouTube is good because there's no censorship. But now YouTube is becoming like a censorship thing, because you can't express the beauty of YouTubing or YouTube is because you get to express yourself without fear of censorship. You can say whatever you want. You can say hi or Heil Hitler. You can say fuck you, Najib. You can say anything, and there will be no repercussions. Unless Najib hires an assassin, then you're fucked. But that's besides the point. Some of the YouTubers that I follow, the ones here I do not follow at all. Sometimes I stumble upon jinnyboy's videos on Facebook, and I just watch a bit, then I don't subscribe. I'm not sure why. No idea. But he's a very famous YouTuber. I do not know how many millions of subscribers he has. The secret of YouTubing is, if you make your content as small and short as possible and as funny as possible, you already hit gold. you'll be drowning in pussy and money as well. Instead of, like me, drowning in sense or pebbles. No matter how... These doors are very heavy. So, now I'm in the Mandarin Oriental. So thank you very much, Influence Asia. Hashtag. You see a lot of influencers around. If you go into, like, say, whatchamacallit, all shopping lots, right? Like, say, Panasonic, they invite influencers like beauty, Instagrammers and whatnot, the people who can influence the young, because they have Instagram account that has a lot of followers. The more followers that you have, the more these companies will take notice, like Panasonic, maybe Sony. I don't think Sony is more... Sony's not more into the younger crowd, it's more on the established, good photographer fellas, so I don't think they are into the young crowd at all. But it's all up to the companies to harness the power of the youth. And I say power of the youth is people who are influencers, influencers for the younger generation. Nowadays it's the Instagram society, Facebook society, YouTube society, so free media, of course, I have said it many times, is dead and buried, but we still need them. Like a cancer. Ah, shit, I shouldn't say that. So some of the YouTubers that have inspired me, of course, is Casey Neistat, whom I have never ever subscribed to until recently, because I just simply subscribe to a lot of the content providers or YouTubers really and nearly, because I don't watch YouTube much anymore, because I'm so busy with all this YouTubing around. I'm vlogging outside P3, for the P3. Some other YouTube who does vlogs, Casey Neistat, of course, is very, very good example, no matter what you think about his ancestry, which is Jew, and he looks like Gollum of Lord of the Rings. He has a very good work ethic. Excuse me. It's a very good work ethic. Works every day, doing vlogs. It's quite inspiring, but when you look at the formula, it's almost the same shit. Time-lapse in beautiful areas, New York. What I like about it is because he does it at the day itself and he posts it at the day itself. So you are actually having a small snippet of what happened in New York on that very day, and you get to watch it. So that's the beauty of it. Instead of accessing some CCTV camera and whatnot, so you just go into Casey Neistat's YouTube channel and just watch the fucking shit that he does every day. Another one who is more inspiring than Casey Neistat, of course, is DG Bro. His anime anal, this is. A lot of exhaust gas here. His anal, this is. It's pretty good, but I don't watch it anymore. What I'm interested in is his vlogs. His vlogs about life, about analysis, about what's happening to the world and stuff like that. YouTube, he talks about YouTube as well, how much it makes, and not much at all. And reliance on all those other, not only AdSense, but GoFundMe or Patreon to get some money. Thank you very much, Wilson Lee, for contributing $5 every month. You can buy 2 meals, I think. Or was it 3? Never mind. 2 meals, Wilson Lee. Nice. One. So hopefully you enjoyed the video. DG Bro, go and subscribe to him. Actually, his main channel is DG Bro. That's for the anime. If you're not interested in anime, then go for the DG Bro After Dark. Holy shit, it's quite warm in here. Fuck. It's not raining just now, right? I was wearing glasses, so I'm not sure whether it's raining or not. So go and subscribe to his YouTube channel called DG Bro After Dark. That's where he does his vlog, his analysis, his current situation. It's very interesting. Go just listen to him prattle while you do some other work, like putting the kidnapped victim in the closet or tightening the ropes on the kidnapped victim or your sex slave or something like that. Or do something like vacuuming the whole house or something like that, or dusting and whatever. It's nice to actually just listen, because it's like something like a podcast already. So hopefully you enjoyed the damn video, hopefully. I'm not going to go to Zouk to party because no space. Already seen all the stars, so I don't need to see them anymore. Ink PR, thank you very much. So do check out Ink PR if you are into all these events and you want to get somebody who can help you to do the events. So Ink PR is the company that does events or helps you organize the events. Gushcloud, of course, thank you very much for the event of this hash influence. Not the smoking hash, okay. Hashtag influence. Lovely, lovely, lovely. It's almost similar to the academies. Almost similar, except for the unrecognizable people. Never mind. It was a fun ride. Jessica Jung was awesome. Two songs, holy shit. And the girls next to her, shit, man, they were shaking their asses. Oh, kill me. No, don't kill me now. Sayonara, bye-bye.